7. No Man's Sky reboot. Dune. The stories. And only doing these side things to advance what's required to advance the story. Okay, let's see what time is left. 15. Set a timer for 1 hour.
Okay, 1 hour and counting.
Hey Siri, how many days until November 12, 2020?
It's 29 days until then.
Woo! 29 days to the mighty PlayStation 5. There's a shooting star. Alright. So. Look how my ship lands. Like, there it is. That's how the base is set up. It's like it lands in this hole, sticking in the ground, as you can see. I'm looking out my, see, it's like submerged in the dirt. But anyway, okay, let's get her a little base reward. Data recovered, 32%. New data available. Search the archives. They came up from surrounded, back above ground now, but they are following me. Should never have touched the eggs. Whales. Okay, blueprints. What do we got? Multi-2 technology data extracted, downloading plans. Personal first field plans restored. Well, it says exosuit movement. All right. Okay. Okay. The thing is, I'm gonna have to expand. I need more slots. So you know, we're not gonna do this now. I need this inventory. Okay, and back to the main mission. Let's see what we got here. Alright. Okay. In the galaxy map, search for a red solar system. Access the galaxy map. Blah blah blah. Visit Hyperion to purchase plans for Canyon Drive. Okay. Now, I'm just going to visit these guys as long as I'm here. See what's up? Ask about the Viking. You know all about the Viking, traveler. Do you not remember? Think. To be working together, traveler, this is the way of the Korvax. Scientist is quite a contrast to the slightly unsettling Gek already at home with him at base. They see the world with such a straightforward excitement. Their enthusiasm is infectious. Agree? The Kovacs buzzes and flashes their lights in a way that can only mean they are happy. Okay, so we're gonna jump in here. We're gonna visit Hesperia. Hyperion. Okay, Hyperion, here we come. That's what they said. Hello? Okay. Everybody's using VR.
Nice.
Except your controllers are backwards, or your hands are twisted. Alright, good to see you soon.
COVID!
Burns a lot of units. Let's get a little bit of units. Okay, infestation. That's an easy one. Dude, come up here. They stand still and they're easy pickings if you stand up on top of the ship. They won't chase you if you stand up here, dude. Join me. We can't get you up here. Let's collect that paycheck. This for about 45 minutes to an hour. I'm gonna call it a night. S-class freighter, man. I've not got one yet. I'm only on class A. Were you hunting for it or just found it by dumb luck? It's a nice surprise that way, though, sometimes. Visit Hyperion to purchase plants for Camden Drive. Hyperion, is that a character? I forget who the hell that dude is. Hyperion. That's Henry, that dude.
All right, I'm going to get a drink.
Let's see here. See, we need three of those. Right. So I get back to that main story mission. Okay, in the galaxy map, search for the red solar system. No traveler, do not speak up. The life form looks at me, traces of fear and surprise behind their eyes. It is clear they have not the more saved me. Leave. Alright, let's see here now. Let's see where the thing is. See the little icon pointing to it. What the heck? Thank you. planet detecting a local system launched into space.
So for a war planet.
Land. Let's see, so they're in deep water clams. Thank you. Construct soul engine. Okay, we got that. Now what? Space station scrap dealer available. Ah, we're doing this. Refined glass. Oh.
Actually, three.
That objective done. Now what? Hollow terminus detected. Okay, another piece of the story. Here we go. Multiple signal sources available. The tower hosts a powerful transmitter designed to facilitate blah blah blah. Tune to Artemis. Activate the mind arc. I do not know what to expect. Some show of light and fury. Some catharsis where Artemis emerges in the flesh, restored to life before my eyes. But it is not to be. One moment I see their hologram, and the next there's nothing. The stranger who gave me these blueprints beckons me over, their signal still active. Travelers are a dream, an idea that we have some special place in the universe. Artemis had it, you had it, Apollo too. Though they would conceal it. Even I had this dream long ago. We are countless, my friend, walking these worlds, yearning for friendship. No one wants to be alone, not truly. But the closer you get to the others, the more you risk hurting yourself, hurting them. The deepest secret of the universe is not that of glass. Or the Aerons, or the Progenitors. It is the final act, the decision to abandon those who need you. It is the primal sin, the foundation of existence itself. Go to the stars, traveler. Your friends wait for you. They will help you bring peace to poor Artemis. Return when you are finished. We have much to discuss. A copy of Artemis has been stored in the Mine Ark. Fly to the space and fly into space and summon the anomaly. So I've made a copy of his being.
We speak with Nal, is now what?
Friend entity, Polo observed your signature approach, but it was anomalous. The signature was from the wrong time. Are you well? Not incomplete, not fading. Not as visor light flares, burning with concern and distress. Reveal the Mind Ark. I tell Nada about Artemis, about Noel, and about the Mind Ark. It glows brightly as I reveal it. It is an echo. I never thought to see a traveler soul. You are so beautiful, but friend entity, this Artemis echo is in pain. Disconnected, the Ark is no rescue. Ask why. Artemis echo will never have a body again. Will never explore again. Old life gone, but we can help them. Nada has a machine. No, not a machine. It is something living, a refuge. There is a choice. You may upload Artemis Echo to the machine, to sub-simulation, where they may live on. I hope Artemis Echo end suffering. Ask if there is another way. Nada shakes their head strangely, trying to adopt my own mannerisms. The gesture is appreciated, if disconcerting. You must choose. Upload them to machine, to sub-simulation, where they may live on. I'll help Artemis Echo end suffering. Ask about simulation. I ask what life would be like inside the simulation. Nada pauses for a moment, staring at me strangely. Nada tells me Artemis would still feel joy at the things they experienced. But if they should learn of their fate, that they were alone, no longer real, unable to meet their friends, such knowledge may cause them great pain. You must choose. Upload them to machine, to sub-simulation, where they may live on, or help Artemis Echo end suffering. Well, I have decided. Go and speak with Polo Traveler. They will help you collaborate the machines, no matter what your decision. Whatever you do, I am proud of your compassion. You are a traveler friend. Nada told me what you need to do. Just know, friend, that we support you no matter the choice. I will prepare the machine. It is Nada, friend's private refuge. Please treat it with care. Decide Artemis' fate at Nada's private terminal. See, now, for me personally, since I don't believe in life after death, I just think we cease to exist. For me, I'd want to go in simulation and just keep on going for immortality. But not to suggest it, then they cannot be with their friends, which implies that Artemis could be with friends. So, I shall end it. The machine is ancient and powerful, a relic of a world long since destroyed. The craft is extraordinary. It is thoroughly tended to often with great love. I feel a whisper, not as faint hum, over the speaker as they commune with the machine. The words on the panel unscramble themselves. Nada entity, authorization detected, secondary simulation, right enabled. This relic is a simulation of a solar system, a prayer offered by ancient Kovacs to the Atlas, now reshaped at the heart of the anomaly. A single false solar system so dear to Nada, it will act as home for Artemis should I wish it. I'm going to go with allow Artemis to die this time. Even as I process my decision, Nada's hum takes on a quiet new intensity. I speak, and their voice replies, intelligible now. They talk gently and suggest I place the Ark upon the terminal. I do so, and hear a whisper. Whisper, whisper, whisper. The Ark begins to unfold, twisting from its center, releasing the traveler's soul within. I witness a spark of blue light blaze within the air before me. It fades after a moment, and with it the last remnant of Artemis within this world. I hear another voice over the speaker, intelligible now and reassuring. They tell me that it is done. Artemis is at peace now. They suggest I do not dwell on these moments. They tell me that I did the right thing. Oh, just just out of curiosity. I attempt to send a message into the simulation. It does not work. I do not know what I expected. How could a whole universe listen? Speak with Nada and Pola if you wish to return to space. I'm ready to continue. Change active mission log. You did what you had to, friend. Travel Artemis is free of pain now. Few can say the same. Artemis Echo has been disconnected, freed from a cruel life. You have done well, traveler. Your guilt? It is a sacrifice for the one you called friend. Go on without regrets. Return to space and contact Apollo. Some people say they want to let you paint your spaceship. I don't like that. I think it's kind of cool just to have a variety of them, and like, it makes it special when you find a cool one. If everybody could just paint it any color, say, hey, but now it's like, whoa, I found a cool ship. You know, it makes it special. Are you receiving? The Hollow Terminus is showing available again. Your signal was thought you were gone. It is a relief to hear Apollo again. It feels like we have not spoken in a long time. Explain. I try to recount the experience to Apollo as best I can. The gateway, the strange planet, a vast machine, the Crimson Orb. As I talk, I realize the memories themselves are unstable, that I cannot form them in my mind. It is just a dull arcing red. I tell Paul that I think I saw the Atlas itself. You saw it? You met the Atlas? The Gek, the Korvax, they worship it as a god. I never thought it was real, never thought. Are you alright? I can't imagine what you've gone through. Say it was just a machine. I tell Apollo of the things the Atlas said, how it spoke of travelers and sentinels as if we were protocols, not living things. The way it views us, the way it looked at me, I felt as if life and death were just fragile dreams, not real concepts at all. At least it didn't harm you. And I think there's something in what you've just said. The Korvax pay homage to the homage? To the Sentinels, precisely because they believe them to be the servants of this Atlas. We should investigate further. This machine will lead us to the Sentinel Nest. We'll be rich before we know it. Agree. I tell Apollo I agree. Perhaps the Sentinels and the Atlas are linked. Perhaps this is the path we need to take. But there are other factors now in play. I tell Apollo of Artemis's grave and my encounter with the mysterious traveler, Null. Artemis is dead? I don't. How? Who would... I know I made fun of them, but that was easy. They cared, they believed, and I... What's happened to them? Where have you buried Artemis? I want to say goodbye if I can. Tell them you're of your choice. I tell Apollo that the Null gave me a way of saving Artemis to restore them to a form of life. Apollo is initially excited at the prospect of going to meet Artemis, but I explained that I cannot do it. I would not. It would not have been life, just an empty existence within the simulation. I had to allow Artemis to find peace in death. Ask if this was right. You did the right thing. You tried. Whatever you might be feeling now, know that you are a good friend. I have to go through the portal and join you. That much is clear. We just need to figure out the right glyphs, the right address for the world of yours. Find a monolith. Search for patterns in the data. These things are machines, and we simply need to understand their code and communication. Save the game, and I'm gonna call it a night. Some words. Isn't it weird how it's like one word per thing? It's like that's not really an efficient language teacher. It's like, imagine. And now, the new version of the Rosetta Stone. It's one word per order. Call now for your subscription. You'll get one word per day. Alright.
Alright.
Up here. Okay. Here we go. Anomaly. 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 I see the stone of the monolith. It's immovable, muted silver, and yet something lurks beneath it. It is gray and yet not gray. A crimson calling out from somewhere below its cool surface. Locate a portal. Take the landing. Hey, we stuck it. Nice. That's how you park. Oh boy, do I have enough? Let's find out. Can he go all the way? Can he go all the way without gathering any more resources? Oh boy, here we go. Can he go all the way? Can he do it? Oh, so close. Just three more. Just three more. Unos. Dos. All right. That's how you do it. Traveler capture loop enabled. Anomaly event contained. Capture loop. The portal seems to beg me as I approach. Demand my attention. It requires me to activate it. It requires me to travel on. I am unsure if I should listen. Request this planet's address. Okay, we're going to screenshot that. Relay the portal of the lifts to Apollo. Ah, because they're coming to me. Okay, where's the Apollo terminus? akin to Apollo. Have you found glyphs for your world? I'm almost ready. My suit is upgraded, my stomach's full, and I've hired a get to look after my farm when I'm away. Ask about the farm. Yes, I have a farm. What of it? It's not much, mostly fruit I found in my travels, but I'm hoping to expand. Anyway, this is no concern of yours. We have a porter to attend, do we not? As I look at Apollo, I think of all that I saw within the portal, of what happened to Artemis, and when they walked that same path. I think of the face of the Atlas, of the way Nada warned me not to return to those tunnels. I do not know if the porters are safe. Give Apollo the glyphs. I give Apollo the glyphs, ask them to take care to remember what happened to Artemis. They assure me that they will, promising to see me soon. Before I go, they advise me to find out what I can from the so-called Null. They warn me to be careful, too. Two lost souls, one who cared too much and one who cared too little, their lives have not become what was promised, have they? Every sentient being that has ever lived has felt that way at some point. I know I did. Once upon a time, I was angry, confused at my own solitude. Imagine my surprise when you woke me. Oh, I know you didn't mean to. I know you were just playing around with the portals, but whatever you did, I am here now, and I need your help. The Atlas. It is not what you think it is. Something is happening to the universe. Something I need your help to figure out. Ask why they need your help. The Sentinels do not just keep the peace across the universe. Their motives run deeper than that, seeking out anomalies in the multiversal structure and limiting them from existence. Have you looked at me? What do you think a Sentinel would do if they came across my form? No, it has to be you, Traveler. There's no observatory nearby. Oh, there is an observatory nearby. It will lead you to the location of the crashed freighter of great interest to our investigation. There we will find the first secret, I am sure of it. Know that the Atlas is neither enemy nor friend to us, no more than the air or the wind might be called such names. But it is terrified, it is in pain. And we have a responsibility to help it suffer, no matter the cost. Alright, I could keep on playing this for hours, but we're gonna get my sleep. So we're gonna end today's part 7 today, right now. Peace.